So we are now going to test the theory. Check the theory that plague cholera first and then measles coronavirus. Then an additional theory that is never two coronavirus act at the same time, same place. And this is for preservation reasons. Preservation of what? Preservation of infectability, of capacity to infect and to clear and to prime. So it wants to preserve. So for instance, that's why you first have SARS. First you have nothing because it wasn't considered necessary by the herd. Then you have SARS, short, 8 months, 2002, 2003. Then in 2012 you have a start of MERS, because it takes time to create a peak. MERS, I'm speaking about coronavirus, MERS. It's all the same family, SARS, MERS, COVID. So never at the same time. There is a pause between SARS and MERS because the herd could afford it. And then between MERS and COVID there was kind of a pause as well, because MERS was present until 2020, but there were a lot of places that didn't have COVID in place by 2020. So there is a, at least they are not at the same time. It's not the same pulse as between SARS and MERS, but they are not at the same time because they want to preserve infectability, a capacity to clear and to prime against threats for the herd, threats to extinction. So first plague cholera, then measles coronavirus, clean and prime, and then preserve as soon as possible. That is for the coronavirus, that's not for the measles. The measles is a constant with ups and downs, and coronavirus is one after the other, if possible with a pause. I think in this calling the antibiotic resistance is picked up by the herd, because the antibiotic resistance against plague is from the other century, and the coronavirus are from this century. So the herd is able to pick up a bigger threat. A bigger threat is when there is antibiotic resistance in the class of the plague and cholera. The inventors of antibiotics, don't recall his name, an Englishman, former century, something like 1940, warned for resistance against antibiotics, warned for AMR. And I recall rather well that other scientists, so another publication, well before the year 2000, warned and thought, made rough provision that we would find antibiotic resistance by the year 2013, and that caught my attention. I still remember that. But in fact there was antibiotic resistance to plague long before, but it wasn't really important. important, because the plague, at least for now, kills everything in its location, especially under antibiotic resistance conditions, because it's mortal if without treatment, and if there's resistance against the antibiotics that treat it, then there is no treatment, and especially pneumatic plague, septicemic plague are mortal, so they eliminate the problem, at least if the problem is, I'm sorry, it's a clinical approach that I do, the problem is not a city. If it had been in a city, then possibly the city would be eliminated. And also, World Health Organization is clearly worried about antibiotic resistance, AMR, since 2016 and 2019, because they had important meetings with partners that matter, like even with the industry. I don't think the result was productive, and it that certainly will not be because of the World Health Organization, but because of the partners of the industry. Because World Health Organization wanted to, let's say, eliminate antibiotics in animals to preserve them for humans, but this clearly didn't have a positive result, because as far as I know, nothing really happened. So okay, comparative genomic plague cholera, they have something in common. They have the same resistance plasmids in common. So this is very worrying. The two threats are becoming resistant at the same time against antibiotics. So if the resistance develops in plague, it can pass it on to cholera. If it resistance takes place in cholera, it can pass it on to plague. As I said, cholera killed probably more than 10,000 people in Haiti in 2011, and MERS appeared as a cholera is a cholera too, and MERS appeared in 2012, had its peak later. Plague entered as a cholera in 2013 and probably had its peak in 2014 or 15. So infection with cholera is not only a matter of hygiene, it remains a contagious disease whose source is not only the environment but also infected people and not the inert environment. A study of the comparative genomics in what plague and cholera have in common, and the others, because you have other members in the Yersinia family, genus, and the most modern tools help us in our research to find the genomics in common. So this is the plasmid that they have in common, and that mediates the multiple drug resistance. It's up to 6 or 8 antibiotics that aggressive. It's quite frightening because it was only in less than 8% of the cases in 1994, 1997, and it got increasing to even 99%. That's not here, I have it somewhere else recently. So this resistance in plague, I'm for sure, Yersinia pestis, went up from 8 to 99 point of vibula. 99, that's 100%. That's very, sounds very frightening to me. Increasing risk to public health worldwide. The emergence of this plasmid in many bacterial, pathogens and non-pathogens occupying diverse niches all over the world is an increasing risk to the public health worldwide. This is antibiotic resistance, AMR, is becoming an increasing risk to the public health worldwide. That's how serious it is. And in the next video, I will call, and I try to be a little bit funny. We were saved by the bell thrice before, so we shouldn't try too much in the future or right now. We were saved by the bell, and the bell was, in my opinion, MERS, because it started to prime. The caller was plague, pneumonic plague in February 2013. And the first call was in this district of Madagascar. There could be others, but this is the one that involved only 22 cases, but one case of antibiotic resistance against plague is enough to be a threat for the public health worldwide. I say it in a conservative way. Maybe MERS saved from plague by priming against plague, and it's not just plague, it's against antibiotic resistant plague, which we cannot stop. Only the priming of the herds all over the world can stop, or at least control it to some extent. So pneumonic plague is sometimes abbreviated like PP, it's Yersinia pestis. This one in Madagascar, 2013, February 2013, was resistant, at least, against streptomycin. And streptomycin is the current recommended first-line treatment in Madagascar. So this is all very serious. And in my opinion, very welcome that MERS, coronavirus, stepped in to prime, because this antibiotic, streptomycin, had become unable to stop, and if it stopped, it would be unable to